you can see this is compound pendulum apparatus, and this is the rod, and you can see there are the two bobs over here, and you can move this bobs up and down and you can change its length. So the center one should be the G, and its length from the center to here is H. It will be H. For example, if you are going to see in this diagram, so there, this is a small H and this will be the small L. So the small L is what the difference between the two bobs. So this will be the two bobs, and you can move this these two bobs by using L and T. You will put the L and T over here and you can move it up and down. So you can change its position. So what we have to do, we have to do in this experiment, I will put this rod, this is a compound pendulum apparatus, and I will push it and rotate it, and I will count its one oscillation from to and fro motion from here and here. So I can put it here, but it cannot be like this because I have to put this notch back up because there is a small notch over here. So what I am going to do over here, I am going to put this compound pendulum over here. And now I will start the stopwatch and I will push it. So we'll start moving. So when it will get stopped, so I will take the reading. So how much oscillations I will count it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. When it gets stopped, so you will take the value of the time as well. So this is still moving, you can see it is still moving. And how can you do this calculation? So you have to find out the practical values at different seconds, how much L and H. You can change the value of the L and you can also change the value of H. And if you want to make H fixed, so you can make a small H fixed. If you want to take L different, so you can take it different, it's up to you. So time period for 20 cycles, how much? So you have to calculate the time, and then you have to find out according to the formula, and then what you have to do, you have to do you have to find out the percentage error over here. So this is the way to perform the compound pendulum practical over here, because you are going to calculate the time period of the compound pendulum and compare it with the theoretical values. This one is the experiment in which you have to calculate the time period for the compound pendulum and compare it with the theoretical value. So how can you do that? I already told you in the practical what you have to do. There were two balls over here. So you can change its position. And how can you change its position? By using Allen key. And Allen key is available in the lab and you can perform this experiment. I already told you. So this is the rod. And what you have to do, small h is this. This is the center. And you have to take its length. And you can change this small h and this L as well. Okay, then. This is the center point of this rod. And you can change the position of the balls from here and there. So you can fix one ball and you can take another ball in the variable condition, or you can variable distances. So you can change its position, whatever the position you will change for the ball. So that ball length from the center point from the rod is a small h, and what is the distance between the two balls is a small l. So hopefully it will be clear to you, all of you. And what we have to do, let me tell you. First, this is the observation table in which what you have to do, you have to calculate the time period, analytical result, and you have to put practical result here. So you can fix one thing, or you can change both the things, or you can change, put one thing is variable and the other thing is constant. For example, if you are changing is L, so what it will be, small h is fixed. For example, if you make h is variable, so you will make L is fixed. And if you want to make both variables, so you can change it and you can take different readings over that. And this is the formula for the calculation of the time period. You can do it analytically by using this formula. And after that, when you have done with it, so you have to compare the results of time period of compound pendulum obtained experimentally and analytically. So what we have to do, let me discuss with you. For example, you have to take the time period from the 20 oscillations. Okay, you have to write down the time period, you have to calculate the time period. How can you do that? Obviously, as you do in the simple pendulum, you have to start and leave it for 20 escalation, and when you start it, so you have to start your stopwatch, and when it completes its 20 oscillations, so you have to calculate the, you have to stop your stopwatch, and you will get your another reading. So that is the time period you will get it from there. So what is happening for you have to take one reading for this, second reading, third reading, fourth reading, and fifth reading. And how can you do these calculations? Let me tell you. Okay, then what you have to do, you have to calculate time period analytically. How can you do that? 2 pi, obviously, 2 into 3.14, mass is small m, and what is capital M? So small m and capital M will remain same, that is 0.4 kg. And what you have to do for the capital K, K is equals to L over under root 12. Now what you have to do, you have to put the value of small m equals to capital M equals to 0.4 kg. This was the mass of the ball, and the mass of the ball, two balls is same there. So you will put it there. Then what you have to do, capital L, you will get it, or you can say it is a small L. It is written in the formula. You can see over here, this one is L. This one L and this one L is capital L. So what you have to do, capital L, you will get it from the table for whatever the length you are taking it. So let me tell you here. So let me tell you one thing over here. Let me share you my screen. If your capital L is coming out here, you can write it down small l as well. So whatever the L is coming out over here, so you will put it here for the first reading when you are calculating analytical result for the first reading. So you will put a small l here, and you will put a small h from here. And how can you calculate the value of K? You will put this L value, this first value for the first reading, put it here on the in L, and divide by under root 12, you will get the value of a small k. And what is gravity? And you know it very well. Gravity is 9.81 meter per second square. So this is the way you can do your calculations. So let me share your screen. Let me share my screen over here. So for example, if your first value is coming out to be 0.62, and I can write it down small l, because it is written in the formula, it is a small l. So 0.62, whatever the length value is in millimeter or meter, you should write it down with this. A small h, you have 0.46 millimeter or centimeter, so you have to convert it into meter. And capital small k, what it will be equals to, so I will add it here, what I will insert equations over here, new equation, and I will put fraction over here. So what I will put it here, I will put the value of 0.62 is L, and here will what it comes, it will come under root. So I can put it from insert symbol as well. Let me see. Yeah, here it is. So I can put 12. When I increase its size, so it will be, hopefully it will be more clear to all of you. So you will get K for every reading, it will be different. So you will get different time periods from here. So you have to put all these values in it, and you will get your time period for the first reading, for the second reading, third reading, fourth reading, fifth reading. So you will get different time period theoretically and practically. Now, student, what you have to do for the compound pendulum experiment, you have to plot the graph between L or time period. You can also plot the graph between H and time period when you make it H variable. So how can we do that? It's up to you how many graphs you want to construct it. So let me take this scatter graph, and I am going to select data over here and add it. So compound pendulum. Theoretical, or you can write down analytical, whatever you look it fine or it good. So an x-axis you have to take L, it is in the increasing order. So, and on y-axis you have to take analytical result for the time period. So it's done, okay. And then what I have to do, I will add here compound pendulum. What are the, where the heading you want to select it, you will do it accordingly. So I'm just taking assumed it. So it's up to you. You will select the good heading for this practical result. And an x-axis you will take L, small l. On y-axis you have to take practical result of the time period. So you will do it like this. Okay, done. And then I'm going to take, give it axis title, chart title and legend over here. So what you have to do in conclusion, what you have to discuss, you don't write, need to write down the definition or procedure. So what you have to tell, as the L, small l is increasing or h is increasing, so what is happening for on the time period? For example, it is increasing with the increase of a small l, so you should write down in your conclusion. If it is decreasing, you should write it down in your conclusion. So in the start it is increasing and then suddenly it gets down, then again it is started to increase. So this value is looking me irritating because it's not giving a proper value here. So I can omit this value from here to make a smooth graph. So what can I do? For example, I delete this value. So what is happening? It happened nothing. So control V, control Z. So which value is making a problem? 65. So let me delete this column and check it out what is happening over here. Entire row. So you can see it, you will get the final graph. So hopefully you will understand it. You can make a proper graph like this and or make it more finer according to your choice or your thinking ability. Hopefully you will get it. How can you construct the graph and how can you draw it with respect to L, with this L versus time period, or you can draw it H versus time period. If you make H is variable, you can make it easily by changing the position of the balls on the rod. So hopefully you will get my point. Thank you so much.